What's going on, guys? And welcome back to some more Mario Golf for the Game Boy Color. In the last part, we beat good old Putz, and we're out of the Marion course. In this part, we're going to do the first of the side missions. This is Diamond Raids. Don't forget, pick up after tee off. So, we cannot go to this area unless we've beaten Putz. So, these darn kids, balls everywhere. Don't everyone help me pick up these balls? Can you do me a favor? I want you to hit these balls into that circle. See, get them in the circle like this. But don't take too long, I'm pretty impatient. Anyway, so we have a little bit of a time limit to actually get these in the circle. Now, you don't have to get it exactly in the first shot, you just have to get it in the circle, but yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to put some oof in the putt, but yeah, that's the first ball. So I don't think you have to get all of them in, but you just have to get. I think you have to get a lot of them in the almost all of them in the circle. There are times I've been able to win it without getting all of them in the circle, but I think all you get is a bonus amount of experience when you put them all in the circle. But that's two in the circle now. They're gonna go in the circle. Okay, I just need to putt it. If you run out of time, basically, it's gonna, you have to start this over, basically, but, I think that should be good. Did I overshoot that? I overshot that. But it doesn't matter, because, alright. There we go. Oh, yeah. Alright, so, we're gonna use a pitching wedge. I think I overshot that. Oh shit. No! You're too slow. I'll do these, do the next bunch. Anyway, so that's what actually happens if you fail that. So, I think I had to start that over if you fail that, but I don't know, but, I'm a little distracted because I have to commentate, but, well, we ran out of time, we still got an end, so, on the green, at least. I went in the, no, I didn't go in the circle exactly, but, alright, so I think we're gonna, didn't go in the circle, but we can put it in the circle, basically. Oh, okay, the pitching wedge guarantees it goes over the water, but, go in the circle, yes. Oh shit. Well, this either goes in or no, but that's it. These are fine, I'll do the rest. Anyway, so we cleared that anyway. We did, thank you so much. And we gained 50 XP and we got a level up. So we're gonna put up our impact and control. Anyway, so I guess what we can do now is I'll go over here later, but if we go over here, this is the golf clinic. All right, want your shot, Judge? Yes. Now we have to get a perfect shot, so not a perfect shot. Obviously, the dialogue, at least if you fail a perfect shot, but that can't be a serious shot. If it is, you need to perfect it. We don't judge miss hit, so want your shot, Judge? All right, so let's try this again. Took me 3 tries to actually get that perfect shot. Now, as long as it doesn't go in the rough, I don't think they count it either. But this basically tells us what our stats are. But You have an average shot that draws a bit. It's a tad low. The area is large, but less waver. It's a ball that needs carrying and easy control. It feels light, timing's easy, and aim's decent. But yeah, that's the golf clinic. Now, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go to the Palms Club Caddy Master's office. So, we're just gonna go to the Palms Club practice courses. So, I think it's, I'm practicing wind shots. Wanna study with me? Yes. If you ever hit it right, but don't get to the pin, it's like you didn't gauge the wind. If your club only gets you to the middle of the green, you can only come up short, but a higher club, it puts you over, so you have to conserve strength, too. For an accurate iron shot, the power is fine. Next, choose a club. So she's choosing a 2-iron. So I think we might need a, what are we gonna need? I love this music, by the way, but, yeah, it looks like we're gonna need a 2-iron, but, that should do it. That's a good shot. Please count it. There we go. We got 25 XP, so, and we got another level up, so, let's go, we'll have to up our fade a bit, but, I'm working on intentional shots. Yeah, purposely curving my shot when I try it, yes. On harder courses, if you can't hook and slice, you won't make score. Intentional shots help you if you're stuck between train. That 3 blocks you from getting the good lie from here, so yeah, it basically teaches us how to use the, how to put, like, hooks in a shot and all that, like a fade or a draw, like in his case, he's gonna put a draw in a shot, but, we can get around, like, trees and all that. Alright, so what we're gonna do now is, we're gonna basically hit the ball. Press if we can hit on the fairway. I don't think they count if you don't hit on the fairway, like I didn't right here. Time is key, but intentional shots keep trying. Sorry, so it looks like we have to aim it a little to the right. This should do it at least. And that's a good shot. That's a better shot. You hit a tree, but it's still covered very nice. And we got 25 XP, and now we're gonna go to approach. This guy. I'm trying to see a bunker shot. Interested? Yes. You need the right club to explode sand and free the ball for a bunker search in the green sort with your sand wedge. A bunker that guards the green is a guard bunker. From the ball to the pin, I'd say it's about 20 yards. First, choose an approach. Next, choose a club. Carry 15 yards and roll at 5 yards. I'll try with the sand wedge. Alright, so what we're gonna do is do the same thing. Just see if we can get on the green. Get close to the hole at least. But that's a good shot. Almost went in, actually. Yeah, you got it. Try putting throwing it too, and we got 25 XP, and I'm trying running approaches on sloped greens, but get a sense of distance. Sorry, I'm gonna try. Yes, on a sloped green, try to get a sense of the distance to be climbed. Also, keep in mind that you can't calculate the run from the fairway. Doesn't say it's climbed from the ball to the pin, but if you don't get my ball at that hill, I won't make par. First, check the distance, then a club, but looks like she's gonna putt it, so we have to kind of do the same thing. It's telling us basically how to putt from the fairway and all that, but let's try. I think this is good. Port thou. I guess it's hard, but since the distance is key, we'll try it again. We'll put more oomph in that putt. How about this? Yeah, that's better. Hey, you're good. I'm gonna train so I won't lose. Anyway, so we get 25 XP and another level up. I'm gonna put more drive. Anyway, so we're gonna go putting now, and this is the last thing we'll do. But let's go for some putting. It's this guy to talk to. Doing the Marine Club tournament? Yes. Can't figure on? Yes. Also, I love this music in the putting more than I like the music in the Marion Club. It just reminds me of like classic Game Boy music. It really just gives me like a nostalgic feel because like I really love like Game Boy music in general. But oh shit, yeah, we're not gonna get a perfect 10 on that, unfortunately. I don't find it hard to win the putting minigame because regardless of what course you're doing, you have to get 7 in. There's more of these challenges when you're playing Advanced Tour, but, that reminds me of, like, a music from, like, Dr. Mario and all that. Yeah, that's a better putt. We just have to make 7, we're good. Not gonna make 7. Hold on, is that in the circle? That's in the circle. Oh my gosh, is right. Let's put more oomph in that putt. So, yeah, as long as it's in the circle, that's fine. We have enough to win it, so, we don't get the extra XP, unfortunately. Here's something else, kid. Now notice how good your putting is, and we get 25 XP, and, yeah, so I think we're gonna cut it off for this part of Mario Golf for the Game Boy Color, so, next time on Mario Golf for the Game Boy Color, we're gonna do the Palms Club tournament. See you guys then.